Shall we lift up our two hands to heaven and celebrate this God that is mighty to deliver and mighty to set free? Would you give him praise? Celebrate him, magnify him. We are all over the places during the Christmas season. He brought us back safely. Give him glory and praise. He made a season of joy for us. Give him thanks. He kept our going out and our coming in. Celebrate him. Now speak to him. Don't mutter words. Don't just assume you are speaking. Speak. I thank you, Jesus. You have proved again that you are mighty to deliver, mighty to set free. Thank you. Thank you for keeping everyone going out and coming in. Blessed be your name. Now, thank him for another brand new year, would you? Thank him for another brand new year. Jesus, I thank you for this brand new year. I celebrate you, Jesus. There is no one like you. Thank you for the grace granted me to see this new year in the precious name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' precious name, we have given thanks.
Amen.
Would you ask him to speak to you? Because one word from God can turn anybody's life around 360 degrees. Jesus, speak to me today. Speak to me in person. Speak to me directly. Help me to catch your word today. Help me to catch what you are saying today. Jesus, speak to me today. The Lord sent a word to Jacob, let it upon Israel. Speak to me today. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed.
Amen.
I pray that today we reposition everyone under the sound of my voice for a most effectual 21 day of prayer and fasting.
Amen.
I pray that this fasting season will be a new dawn season for you indeed.
Amen.
You will encounter God.
Amen.
God will appear to you.
Amen.
He will speak to you in person.
Amen.
He will respond to your prayers practically. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Give the Lord a big hand of praise. It's my new dawn era. Please get seated, everybody. Amen. It is taking responsibility that makes Christianity meaningful. Nobody can be saved on behalf of another. So to be saved, you have to personally repent and proclaim Jesus as your Lord and Savior. To be healed, no matter how sick you are, you have to believe in Jesus the healer and believe in his healing word to be healed. To prosper, you have to embrace the provisions of the covenant that stipulates the conditions for assessing his prosperity. Everything about you and me in the kingdom demands that we recognize our own part of the deal for delivery. Unfortunately, many keep waiting, like the man at the pool of Bethesda, for someone else to take their responsibility for them. anniversary of frustration at the same spot. Because he won't take his part of the deal. As for empowerment, go to them that said, and buy for yourself. Matthew 25 and verse 9, and you know, oil symbolizes power. Nobody can be empowered on behalf of another one. And one of the demands of empowerment is, my soul thirsted for thee, and my flesh longed for thee to see thy power. So it is fasting to see the power of God. Amen. Amen. To change level in the school of power, it takes fasting. Amen.
Amen.
Everything that makes you is traceable to your taking responsibility. Everything that makes you. Everything that makes a believer demands that that believer takes responsibility. Everything. Every commandment of scriptures hold definite benefits to whosoever embraces them. God's word is packaged for our profitable living. All scriptures. How many of them? Is given for by the inspiration of God and is profitable. Its doctrines are profitable. Its reproofs are profitable. Its corrections are profitable. And his instructions are profitable.
Amen.
This is very vital. This is very important. If you must make the most of your glorious destiny in Christ, then be ready to take responsibility. Be ready to do what? Revelation does not drop on people's laps. Those who seek shall find. You seek for it. You don't study, you don't meditate, you won't find revelation. You don't walk in law, it won't flow. We just must take responsibility. The 21 days ahead of you and me is loaded. If you will take responsibility. If you will take responsibility. We must wake up and take responsibility, lest we be 38 years on the same spot. Like that man living a pitiable life at the beautiful gate. As the Lord liveth, the 21 days ahead of you will rewrite your story. It will rewrite the story of your family. It will rewrite the story of your generation after you. Somebody believe that? Let me hear your loudest amen. Prayer does not require partnership for answers. He that asketh, not they. He that asketh, receiveth. He that seeketh, findeth. To him, not to them, not to the team, that seeketh, the door shall be opened. Hannah had no partnership. She got her answer. David was a one-man ever-winning army. One man. One man. He went to God, 1 Corinthians, 1 Samuel 30, verse 6 to 9. Shall I pursue these troops? That's creating heartache for the whole land. Shall I overtake them? And the Lord said, pursue. For thou shalt surely overtake them and without fail recover all. What? One man. One man got directed from God and went after the troops and overran them. And he said, this be the spoils of David. They recovered all. Nothing was missing. Prayer does not require partnership for delivery. this pray for me, pray for me, pray with me syndrome is religious. Religious. I was hanging around the mountains alone with the white beast there. Me and them were beasts together. I was praying one night, so some monkeys were jumping down from me. I said, stop there! He said, shh, you don't know they hear grammar. Stop there! I said, shh. Man. Prayer does not need partnership. My prayer partner, what if it's not willing to partner? Then you'll be in the same spot forever. 1979. I said, brethren, the time of brethren, let's go, is over. I'm gone, if you're interested. I'm gone. I don't wait for you when I'm going for prayer. And when I get there, it's not that I'll be praying with you. You'll be praying on your own, I'll be praying. I don't know whether you believe what you are praying or not, so, but I believe what I'm praying. So I go with people once a while, but each one prays his prayer. Praise God. Brother David, are you going? Yes, I'm going. I want to go. Why not? You stay there. Prayer does not require partnership for delivery. Stop playing religion. Stop playing religion. David again prayed, shall I go down to the Philistines? He said, go, you go. Then the Philistines gathered again and said, shall I go? He said, no, don't go. Wait a bit for the moving of the mulberry tree. When you see that, bestir yourself. And you will deal with them. He was having it himself and God. God said, I see for a man, not I see for a team. Mm-hmm. Somebody's prayer here will change the fortune of our nation.
Amen.
Somebody's prayer here will meet the needs of multitudes in this church.
Amen.
Now, so Jacob was left alone and returned with a change of name. Believe in your individuality and take full responsibility, because everybody is absolutely responsible for the outcome of his life. Amen. Everybody is absolutely responsible for the outcome of his life. 21 days of unforgettable encounters is just ahead of you.
Amen.
Let that be behind your mind. It's not about we pray and I pray. One time I said, look, if it's your prayer that's helping me, okay, pray for yourself. Because all this religion, you know, we are praying for you. It's okay. There's nothing wrong. I need your prayers. But don't let it be that you are praying for me. It's the reason why you are failing. I'm praying for you every day, publicly, privately. Okay, why am I not failing? Why am I not going and announcing to you, I'm praying for you, I'm praying for you? What is my job if I'm not doing that? But take responsibility. Lord, I need answer to these questions. Jesus, let the first 3 days deliver this answer to me. You know, I kept shouting, get serious. Get serious. The more serious you are with God, the more glorious your adventure becomes. Get serious. I've been in it for some time. Get serious. I don't have a group I'm meddling with. I don't. You can't talk with me any other ministry in my place. I don't have the time. I don't gang up against anybody. I'm for everybody. I need to get to where I'm going. Please settle down and get serious. Sir, Elijah alone prayed. He said, was a man. He was not a team. Elijah was a man like you and me. He prayed and the nation rose and said, the Lord is God. Baalism ended by one man's prayer life. Evil will end in Nigeria.
Amen.
Evil will end in the midst of this commission. No one is permitted to shed tears of defeat this year. No family here will bury any member this year. No door shall be shut against you again. Every manipulation of hell, of your glorious destiny, shall be crushed forever this year. Every closed door to you hitherto shall be reopened within the next 21 days. It's time to get serious with God. It's time to get serious with God. I have one of my old friends here. He said, anytime I said, look, we'll see tomorrow morning. He said, what is wrong with Brother David? Every time inside the bush, can't you pray in the house? No, I'm too serious for the house. You may come and greet me while I'm praying. And I don't need greetings. I want to go and greet God. Amen. It's a long time before I believe in praying in the house. Okay, who is praying in the forest? You can't go and visit a man at 12 midnight on the hill. Do you know where he is? There's no light except torchlight, which you put in your pocket. And it's only when you need to go that you turn it on, you want to read. Let's get serious. Can I tell you this? Every limit on any aspect of your life shall be lifted off. Yeah. Say with me, prayer does not require partnership for answers. I am responsible for the outcome of these 21 days of prayer and fasting. Not my prayer partner, not my team. I am responsible. How many 21 days you can decide to sleep all through the night? Or start dozing all day. And then we finish 21 days and say, in theory, anything. That's not you. Every person called barren will be pregnant within these 3 weeks. Every besieged marital destiny shall be rescued this time. Every molestation of sickness, he said, then shall your head spring forth speedily. Speedy restoration of health. That shall be your portion. You know, there are many people here, you never know sickness again till you meet with Jesus. And many who believe in it will be here 100 years old. Amen. Prayer does not require partnership for answers. I sought for a man, one man, not a team, who will stand in the gap that I may not destroy the land. I sought for a man. Prayer does not require partnership for delivery. Jabez alone prayed, and his fortune was turned around to fortune. Prayer does not require partnership for answers. Our teaching series for the month is captioned Maximizing the Blessedness of Prayer and Fasting. Let's understand that prayer and fasting is a commandment. What is it? It's not an admonition. It's not a counsel. It's a commandment. When ye fast, Matthew 6:17-18. Now, is this not the fast that I have chosen or I have commanded? Isaiah 58:6. So, fasting and prayer is a commandment. And every commandment of the Lord holds specific profit. And from the welcome passage of scriptures we read, we saw the listed specific profit from fasting and prayers. Is it not the fast that I have chosen, that ye lose the bands of wickedness, that you undo the heavy burdens, and that you let the oppressed, or you go free from the oppressions of the devil, and that you break every yoke in your life. Are these not the reasons I prescribe fasting? These are my reasons. Then, of course, verse 8, then shall your light break forth as the morning. Outbreak of revelation. And your head shall spring forth speedily. And your righteousness will go before you. Authority over addictions. That young man says, been on Indian hemp. Don't say smoking. Smoking can be cigarette. This is Indian hemp. That's really smoke. You take Indian hemp, you are smelling from inside out. You can't say you didn't smoke. I've been in the midst of them several times, witnessing Jesus to them. You see smell. Really smell. Human being smelling. It took it last since March last year. Come and say deliverance. Every addiction, pride, arrogance, every addiction, sexual immorality, every addiction, fraud, every addiction, whatever has held anybody bound, in the name of Jesus, by the yoke breaking power of fasting, they are destroyed forever. Thank you, Jesus. So you have those specific benefits that accrue to you. And then shalt thou pray, verse 9, and the Lord will answer. Thou shalt cry, and then we say, here I am. I'm here for you. What is it? Talk to me. So it expedites answers to prayers. Fasting facilitates answers to prayers. Glory to God. And the Lord shall guide thee continually. Fasting enhances your access to divine guidance. You walk with clarity of insight into your future with confidence. Into your future with confidence. Amen. One anointed leader of the move of God in the land was in doubt about my being called to full-time ministry. And I said, but I heard from God directly. He said, no, God has not spoken that to you. I said, I heard him. He said, we shall see. I said, we shall see. Amen. He never lost one out of respect with me because he loved me. But we saw eventually. And he said, I was just trying to know whether you understand what you are talking about or not. Amen. That could be true. I don't think he would lie. And anybody can miss it anyway. Oh, I heard God so clearly. So clearly, I said, Jesus, should I pretend not to have heard you? Let me never succeed in any other thing I do. Fasting clears the atmosphere. It clears the atmosphere. I've had the privilege of hearing angels sing on my fasting and prayer altar. I had shall guide thee continually. And what that means? Goodness and mercy will be following you all the days of your life. When God guides, you cannot goose. Because he will back up the person he guides. He will go before you. He will go with you. He will walk with you. He will walk through you. He will walk for you. Expect to be guided specifically in these 21 days of prayer and fasting. Many are doing 10 businesses. Their future is only one. They now dissipate the energy. And none is counting. Expect God to give you clear direction on where to invest your energy. We're running here and there. Where to invest your energy? Somebody's blessed. And then he said, that will make you like a watered garden and like springs of water whose waters fail not. Supernatural breakthrough on every side. And then there shall be of you. Not talking about your generation after you. Shall be called. They shall build the old waste places. They be making marks and making land. May this fasting time impart on your generation after you. Give the Lord a big hand of praise. Thank you, Jesus. Now, let me say this. You may never find any believer that commands strange order of breakthroughs who is not given to fasting. You never find one. Many are just eating up their destiny without knowing. You never find one. Even Jesus could not break forth until he fasted. You never find one. Paul said in fastings often. You never find one. Oh, poor Esau. You sold your birthright for a morsel of meat. You know how many believers have sold their birthright? Now that we say it's fasting, they are going for medical report. You eat 5 times a day for this period because your blood level is high. And then in the afternoon, it's low. So, I mean, oh, to avoid this thing. Presence changes people's stories. It doesn't kill people.
Yes, sir.
Amen. If it does, I will be dead longest time. It doesn't kill people. As the Lord liveth, your new dumb package will not be lost to your belly. Your new dumb package will not be lost to your belly. Philippians 3:19, he said, their belly is their goal. Genesis 25 and verse 27 to 35, Esau sold his birthright. What is this birthright to me? I'm dying. Jacob, give me. Give me, I beg. Give me. I mean, he begged his way out of his birthright. Jacob said, you know, I'm smarter than you. Your birthright is not in my hand. Poor Esau. Poor Esau. Esau had just a few verses written about him in scriptures, and Jacob had chapters. He ate his birthright. He drank his birthright. You know, in my office, you know, there are certain protocols that we observe, and there are quite a number of meetings in January. So if this verse had been put in March, I would have been part of it. Okay, do your own match. It's not late.
Because it's personal. It's personal. You can't do your own match. There is no cry.
Amen.
Amen.
You know the good news? No matter who's contesting with your new done heritage, you will take delivery.
Amen.
Somebody believe that. Let me hear your loudest amen. Let's quickly examine some 4 approaches that will make fasting and prayer profitable. Number one, for prayer, fasting and prayer to be profitable, we must come confessing and forsaking our sins. The charismatics need to come away to this reality. Never assume forgiveness. God will not forgive anything not confessed. God will not forgive any sin not confessed. And there is no sin that is unforgivable with God. But not without confession. Let us come confessing and forsaking our sins. Proverbs 28 verse 13, the Bible says, whosoever covereth his sin shall not prosper, but whosoever confesseth and forsaketh them shall have mercy. Let's come confessing and forsaking our sins, because sin is a barrier between the believer and God on the prayer altar. His hands are not short that he cannot save, nor his ears heavy that cannot hear, but our sin have separated between us and God, so he will not hear us. 1 John 1:8. If we say we have not sinned, when we have sinned, that's my own understanding of it, I can't confess for stealing, since I've not stolen. Can I hear your amen? If we say we have not sinned, when we have sinned, we deceive ourselves. There's no truth in us. But if we confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive us our sins. No, don't assume forgiveness or you live a separated life from God. Don't assume forgiveness. Actually confess before the Lord. Lord, I'm sorry for this. Now, let me tell you why there's no unforgivable sin with God. We had David. If I hide iniquity in my heart, the Lord will not hear me. Psalm 66 verse 18. And in verse 19, he said, but now God has heard me. That means God has forgiven him. Forgiven what? Sexual immorality. Murder. What? God forgive him. I heard him. He forgive murder. There are many of us with the burdens of sin hanging on our lives. That's just blocking the way forward. Blocking the way forward. You stole yourself, I'm righteous of God in Christ Jesus. No, no, no. That's not the Jesus kind of righteousness. Lord, I'm sorry. What led me there? Deliver me, Jesus. Enough is enough. We need to get to that point to see the way forward. You must get to that point to see the way forward. Some are too proud to see progress. They are just too proud to see, and they know it. You can't be proud and not know. You can't be lying and not know. You can't be changing figures and not know. You can't be stealing and not know. You can't be in immorality and not know. Let's come confessing and forsaking so we can see the way forward. Is somebody going forward here? Glory to God. Yes! None is perfect, but our target is perfection. Let us go on to perfection. Whatever you have overcome now, don't get back there. Then you overcome the next, and overcome the next, until you overcome all. Can I hear your amen?
Yeah.
Come and say, I'm going forward. Without forgiveness, prayer will never be answered. And he said, merciful God, any sin is forgivable with our God. When he sees the travail of the soul of Christ, he will write it off. No assumption. If your supplications and intercessions will not end in frustration, no assumption. Let's come repenting, confessing, and forsaking our sins. Thank you, Jesus. You know, if you are not willing to change your approach, you cannot improve on your results. If you are not willing to change your approach, you cannot improve on your results. Refuse to be offended in God and in men. Number two, for blessed is he whosoever is not offended in me. Somebody was in our fellowship in 1982, and I ministered on, blessed is he who shall not be offended in me. And that was the breakthrough of her life. That was how she got through a barrenness challenge. All the three children are graduates today and are working. She was offended in her mockers. She was offended in everybody that spied her. But when that word came, that word loosed her. And her prayer came true. She got her first miracle son, second miracle son, third miracle son. Amen. She will have been in bandage for life. It's impossible that offenses must come, but woe unto him through whom they come. Luke chapter 17, verse 1. Beware of offenses, both in God and in men. Beware. 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 It is to tie you down. It's to tie. Somebody says you are a fool. He's expressing an opinion. He has a right to it. To now write his name down and be praying against him. You are wasting your time. I mean, for expressing his opinion, which he has a right to. They said to Jesus, you have Beelzebub. He didn't pray against them. Just carry on with your life. Blessed is he whosoever shall not be offended in me. Amen.
Amen.
Do you complain who stepped me in the marketplace? When you go market? Who stepped me? Where? Worker. Before you start looking for that, somebody will push you down. What are you, man? Where are you from? There's still people here. The marketplace is a place where they step on your toes. Yes. If you don't want to step on your toes, stay in your house. Amen. One woman was helping me to price when I was a bachelor, to price meat. The way they insulted her, I said, I'm sorry. She said, that's how it is in the market. He just saw me and said, if you price it, they will cheat you. Let me buy it for you. I didn't know her from Adam. that person said, come and steal it. I fed for her. He said, that's the normal language. Praise God. You call something, maybe 10 naira, and nobody prices 2 naira. Can do that. He said, what of tonight? He said, come and steal. Glory to God. Now, if you don't want such insult, get off the marketplace. You know, we are in the marketplace here. Everybody has a right to say, look at your head. Eh? Look at the way he's walking. Is this man an old man? This man can't succeed though. Can't succeed in anything the way I see him. Now, those are the languages in the marketplace. Let go and let God. Let go and let God. Now, somebody who cannot forgive his wife cannot forgive anybody. Somebody who cannot forgive his children, be afraid of him. He won't forgive anybody. So start this lifestyle of advanced forgiveness from your home. Forgive those children. You know, you'll be a wicked father if your son takes your car against your will and had an accident, and what you are looking for is a car. They say, this man is a witch. He's the one that killed the son. You say, my son, where are you? My son, where are you? The taking of your car is not an issue now. You want a rescue. Amen. Amen. Paul said, here I need to exercise myself to always have a conscience that is void of offense, both towards God and towards man. Now, be free from offenses. Lord, I've been doing this annual prayer and fasting. I've not seen anything, but they say we should do it again. I'm doing for the last time. This, if you don't answer me this time, you won't see me again. Okay. May your helper not turn his back on you. Refuse to be offended. If you must have an adventurous time in this prayer and fasting. Number 3, define your goals and objectives for this fast. What are your targets? What are your prayer projects? Be specific with your demands. Do that today. Because you don't prepare for an exam when that started. Not in the exam hall. The exam kicks off tomorrow, Monday. So get set today. Draw a program schedule. Draw a schedule for your prayer. Draw a schedule for your word search. Define your targets in clearest terms. the whole of Israel prayed under Ezra for God to show the right way for them to go. Ezra 8, 21 to 23. And God did. Jehoshaphat prayed because they don't know what else to do. But our eyes are on you. How do we come out of this? We are besieged. Oh God. Oh God. Come down and help us. They fasted 3 days and heavens came down and God took over their battle. Be specific. Be specific. Be specific. Now, Lord, I'm going at your command into full-time ministry. I want a marching order from you and the things I need to know. So I was in there for 5 days. 5 days and five nights. He unveiled them chapter by chapter. Those things are still speaking today. Amen.
Amen.
He said, exploit is a function of your knowledge of me, not your knowledge of any person. You don't need to know any man to scale the utmost height. Those who do know their God, they shall be strong and they shall do exploit. You see how God delivered me? I will bless you, but thou shalt not borrow. You see how God delivered me? Seven strong pillars were unveiled hanging around Jesus for 5 days on specific terms. What must I take note of as I go? Let's be specific. Draw up your prayer projects. Now, you can slot that into three-day modules, because after 2 days, he will revive us. On the third day, he will raise us up. Every 3 days of this fast will deliver enviable returns.
Amen.
Let me hear your loudest amen.
Amen.
It will be your sweetest fasting adventure since you believed.
Amen.
Your sweetest. You'll be enjoying it so much, you'll be wondering, is it now over? No. 21 days will be like 1 day. Now, wait a minute. You will have an encounter in this fast that will deliver to you in 1 year what labor cannot deliver in 50 years. Yes, God commanded it, but we partner with them in the old site, and God built that church and whatever it is in 3 years. Now, God spoke, and he built this one in 1 year. It's a humorous God. And what am I talking about? You will hit surprises.
Amen.
Enviable surprises.
Amen.
No offense. Finally, number four, engage your heart in seeking the Lord. Engage your heart. You shall seek for me and find me when you shall search for me with all your heart. Jeremiah 29 verse 13. Engage your heart. When thou seest seek my face. Psalm 27 verse 8. My heart says, thy face, O God, will I seek. It's important now to separate between your head and your heart. I must separate between my head and my heart. Because all the issues of life, they emanate from my heart. The Bible says, keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. Every evil emanates from the heart. It's out of the heart. Within the man, cometh, proceed evil thoughts. They come from the heart. So engage your heart to flush out every evil from your thoughts. Engage your heart to secure the hand of God in your affairs. Engage your heart. You shall seek for me and find me when you shall search for me with all your heart. Let's engage our heart. God will appear to us.
Amen.
Let me hear your loudest amen.
Amen.
Because the preparation of the heart in man and the answer of the tongue is from the Lord. Let's prepare our heart. Proverbs 16:1. in seeking the Lord. And it shall be an awesome experience. Very quickly, let's outline some specific blessings that emanate from prayer and fasting. Have we done that initially? God takes over our battles through the altar of prayer and fasting. He did that for Jehoshaphat and the whole of Judah. He will do that for you.
Yeah.
That long-standing battle, God will take it over now.
Yeah.
And when God takes over, it is over. He's taking over that battle of your life now.
Yeah.
You shall not need to fight in this battle. That was response to their fasting and prayer. Set yourself. You see the salvation of your God today. 2 Chronicles chapter 20 and verse 17. And as they began to sing and to praise, God took over their battles. They didn't shoot an arrow, yet they won the victory. You have struggled enough. It's your turn to see the raw hand of God. Prayer and fasting delivers from all satanic yokes. I mentioned that earlier. This can't go anywhere but by prayer and fasting. Whatever has refused to bow, we bow to you now through this season of prayer and fasting. It secures express answers to prayers. Isaiah 58 and verse 9. We read that earlier on. Express answers to prayers. Now, prayer and fasting unleashes divine favor on the life of every engaging believer. We saw that in Nehemiah. He went into prayers and fasting and appeared before the king on a suicide mission. Why is your countenance sad, Nehemiah? Why should I not be sad? The place of my father's sepulchre has been devastated. The walls of the cities of the city of my father has been burned with fire by you. Why should I not be sad? What kind of question are you asking me? Kill me if you want. It's okay. What do you want? I want to go back home and build. You, God bearer, you have savings? No. You will give me wood. You are the one who destroyed it. You will give me wood. And give me soldiers who will follow the wood and all the materials I need. Is there anything more? You won't see me get it when I finish. I'm a suicidal mission. And the king said, I grant you all that you ask because of the good hand of favor upon him. Prayer and fasting unleashes favor. And what labor cannot secure in 100 years, favor will make happen in 1 year. Now, in the name of Jesus, you will return from this prayer and fasting with a baptism of favor. Wherever they have said they don't want to see your face again, they'll be looking for you.
Yeah.
Your name will start answering in places you have never imagined.
Yeah.
They'll be sending for you to provide solutions on what you have never done before.
Yeah.
Amen. That's what favor does. You know, slavery is a spate of misfortune, but not for Joseph that had favor. Joseph became the heir of Potiphar's house and estate. As a slave, without a CV, without guarantor, he became his treasurer, the manager of his estate. He got to the prison, the height of misfortune, and he became a staff as an inmate. Whatever was done in the prison, Joseph was in charge of it.
by favor. He said he gave him favor in the sight of the keeper of the prison. Favor. We rewrite anybody's story at any point. Wait a minute. Wherever you have been cheated, favor will bring restoration. You know, nobody gave us this land. Nobody. Nobody. God did. They got not the hand, the land by their own power. Yes. Their own arm did not save them, but thy right hand, because we had the favor unto them. Amen. Psalm 44, verse 3. He gave us this land. I never saw the ruler of this place once. He saw me when we came here. When we took over this place. When we built this place. I never called on anybody's office. And I tell you the truth in Christ. Never knew where local government was. Never stepped any state house. God gave us. We got a sea of over 530 acres at a go. We are going to hit favor. Amen. Nothing decorates destiny like favor. Nothing decorates destiny like favor. Nothing decorates destiny like favor. From the prayer altar in this fasting season, a new order of favor will bellow on your life. Somebody bless. Give the Lord a big hand of praise. How many are said to take responsibility? He said, deliver yourself, O captive daughter of Zion. You have sold yourself for naught. You shall be recovered without price. Shake your feet from the dust. Rise up. Sit down. Put on strength. You have the answer in your hand. These 21 days ahead of you, they are turnaround days for you. Get ready for it. Men and brethren, I have never added anything to Jesus till tomorrow. Jesus is more than enough. You do what he says, you have committed his integrity to perform. I've never had an alternative to Jesus on any subject in my life. Any. A double-minded person is unstable in all his ways. Let not that man think he shall receive anything from God. Stay focused. The answer is all available on the altar of prayer and fasting. Stay focused. Behold, I will do a new thing. Remember not the former things. Let not the things of old come to your mind. God said, I'm going to do a new thing. And it's going to happen to you. Now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know it? Come and say, I will know it. I'll do a new thing. I've returned again and again from fasting episodes with what money cannot buy. Again and again and again and again. Many of us have such experiences. You have the brightest experience till date this time. Yeah. I said, my God will appear to you. Yeah. You think that Jacob will ever forget, even in heaven now, how he wrestled that night? No. He will appear to you. Amen. He will appear to you. Amen. One more time, give the Lord a big hand of praise. Amen. It starts tomorrow. Preparation should conclude today. Position yourself properly to make the most of the season. Jesus is Lord. Somebody give a testimony in one of the services today. He said, everything we stood for last year came true. And what we didn't ask was added. Everything. So spell out in clearest terms what your goals and objectives are in this fast. And let me admonish you. Never forget. Kingdom advancement endeavors as a priority is God's secret card for meeting
all of your needs are my needs in life. If you will seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, all these things that others are dying to get shall be added to you. And we have that as in the announcement. The various intercessory prayer guidelines, personal spiritual awakening. If it's well with you spiritually, it will be well with you all around. To be spiritually minded is life and peace. To be carnally minded is death. Now, praying for life transforming world in our various services. Now, praying for members of the church, because whatever you make happen for others, God will make happen for you. You are in need. Now, pray for others who are in the same need. And God will meet their needs and meet yours on top of it. And God turned the captivity of Job when he prayed for his friends. Pray for your mockers. God will change your story. Can I hear your amen? And then church growth, intercessory prayer guidelines, new converts retention, that anybody that will be saved this year will abide till Jesus comes. Can I hear your amen?
Yeah.
Intercessory prayer guidelines for fruitful outreaches in our various endeavors and vengeance against all resistances, against the advancement of the church of Christ. I will build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Until vengeance answers from above, the enemy may never give up. That's what we do. So ensure you engage with this. And it will be on the website. You can download. You can do anything you want to do. Then we give hard copies to those individuals who may not have had their copies subsequently. Jesus is Lord. One more time, give the Lord a big hand as we close in this service. Amen. If you are here in this service and you are not born again yet, very crucial in your quest to have answers to your prayers, because you must have a Father in heaven before your prayer can be answered. When you pray, say, "Our Father which art in heaven." If you are here, you don't have a Father in heaven yet, because you must accept Christ Jesus as the Lord and Savior to become a child of God. I would like to pray with you. Wherever you are, stand to your feet, please. He will forgive your sins, and then he will write your name in the book of life, and you become a living child of God. Wherever you are, stand to your feet. You want your sins forgiven? You want to become a child of God? Please stand. God bless you all over this place. God bless you all over this place. God bless you. Thank you, Jesus. Now, there are also people here that need to rededicate their lives to Christ. You need to stage a comeback to Jesus. Maybe you are once saved, but at the point you got offended in Christ, in his word, and you just shifted position. You want to return today. It don't mind that person is unstable in all his ways. Let another man think he shall receive anything from God. Can I ask you to stand up too? Everyone that wants to rededicate his or her life to Christ, please stand. Please stand. You want to rededicate your life to Christ, please stand. Wherever you are, please stand. I pray for you right there where you are. I pray for you right there where you are. Please stand to your feet. This is your chance for a change of story. Stand to your feet. Now, everybody standing, please move towards the closest aisle to where you are. The closest passage to where you are, and I'll be praying for you there. They'll be helping you to fill out your card. Now, if you haven't gotten your copy of the prophetic focus for the month, please signify and ushers will give you your copy. If you don't also have your copy of Welcome to 2018, you're nailed on, and then 2018 winners personalized prophetic declarations, please signify and then ushers will put that in your hand. Everybody standing for prayers, please bow your heads first. You may complete your forms later. Bow your heads first and lift up your right hand before the Lord as I lead you in this simple prayer of faith. You pray this after me, saying, "Lord Jesus," say it loud, "Lord Jesus, I surrender my life to you today. Forgive me all my sins. Wash me with your precious blood. I believe you died for me. On the third day you rose again, that I might be justified. Right now, I believe my sins are now forgiven. I'm justified by your blood. I now proclaim you as my Lord and my Savior. Now, I know I'm born again. I'm a child of God. I'm restored back to the faith. Thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. In Jesus' name, amen." Now, keep your hands up. Lord Jesus, I pray over these precious souls. Your grace has brought them in. Let the same grace preserve them. You shall run this race to the end. No force of the wicked shall drag you back from following Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, it shall be the beginning of a new dawn in your life. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. Congratulations, church. Let's give the Lord a big hand for these people. Please complete your forms and pass them on to those church officials around with you. Shall we all rise? Let the stewards come over to the serving points and let's have the table of the Lord today. First Kings chapter 19, verse 8. We saw Elijah was fed with angels' bread and drink, and he went in the strength of that meal for 40 days and 40 nights. By this communion tonight, this morning, you will go through these 21 days as one day. Yeah. Unusual strength on your prayer altar. Yeah. Unusual insight in your search of scripture. Yeah. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. Anyone that may be sick in his body, via this communion, you are declared healed. Anyone oppressed by the devil, by the blood of the Lamb in this communion, you are set free. Yeah. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Now, I'd like you to take this with faith, because the communion is superior to angels' bread that they fed on in the wilderness. None of them was feeble. You shall not be feeble. Yeah. There shall be no weakness. Yeah. No physical weakness. Yeah. No emotional weakness. No spiritual weakness. All through the 21 days, you just be soaring. No sweating. No struggling. Your prayer life will be a surprise to yourself. The insight from scriptures will be a surprise to yourself. In Jesus' precious name. This table is declared the flesh and the blood of Jesus. And so is every other table set in this service right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus. Give the Lord a big hand. Get seated, and then you'll be directed to your video serving points by the officials. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Now the choir can lead us.
I am on the Lord's hand. I will never give up. I am an overcomer. For the Lord God is on my side. I'm on the Lord's side. I am on the Lord's side. I will never give up. I will never give up. I am an overcomer.
I am an overcomer.
For the Lord God is on my side. I'm on the Lord's side. I am on the Lord's side. I will never, never give up. Never give up. I am an overcomer.
I am an overcomer.
For the Lord God is on my side. Are you on the Lord's side? On the Lord's side. I will never give up.
I will never give up.
I am an overcomer.
I am an overcomer.
For the Lord God
is on my side.
Who is on the Lord's side? I want to know. I am on the Lord's side. Hey, tell me who is on the Lord's side? I want to know. For the Lord,
the Lord God is on my side.
I'm on the Lord's side.
I am on the Lord's side.
Now and forevermore, I will never, never, never. I'll keep on pressing, I'm an overcomer. For the Lord God, for the Lord. Tell me who is on the Lord's side. I want to know.
I am on the Lord's side.
Somebody tell me who is on the Lord's side. I want to know.
I am on the Lord's
side. Hey, are you on the Lord's side?
I am on the Lord's side.
And I will never, never give up.
I
keep on pressing. I'm an overcomer. For the Lord God. For the Lord God. Say, are you on the Lord's side?
I am on the Lord's side.
I will never overcomer.
I am an overcomer.
For the Lord God. On the Lord's side,
I am on the Lord's side. I will never give up.
I am an overcomer. For the Lord, I will let go. I will let go. Jesus took me by the hand, and I will let go. I will let go.
I will let go.
I will let go.
I will let go.
I won't let go, I won't let go,
I won't let go,
I won't let go,
I won't let go,
and I will not let you go. Jesus, I won't let go. Jesus took me by. I won't let go,
I won't let go,
I won't let go.
I won't let go.
Give the Lord a big clap offering, everybody. Amen. How many are set to experience God in a new way? Are you set to experience God in a new way? You will. You can't buy experience. You have to experience experience. You will experience God. And as Jesus prayed, he was transfigured. You will experience God. Lift up your two hands and give him thanks for the encounter you got. Give him glory and praise. The year is your year. He's opening up to you favorably in the name of Jesus. Now give him thanks. Celebrate him. Magnify him in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Amen.
Experience definite encounters on the prayer altar this week.
Amen.
How we start has a lot to do with how we end. Great for a great start. In this prayer and fasting season, receive it now.
Amen.
One man's prayer turned the nation around. Your prayer will turn your family around.
Amen.
It will turn all of your relations around for good.
Amen.
Your prayer will turn this nation around. And turn it around for good.
Yeah.
Your prayers will solve the problems of many in this church.
Yeah.
and turn your own captivities. In the name of Jesus Christ. Shall we together share the goodness of the Lord and fellowship, everybody? God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall forever and ever. Amen. Peace. My new dawn era is here. What eyes have not seen nor ears heard shall be my lifestyle all through this year. Congratulations. Congratulate your neighbors all around you. You'll be hearing that all through the year. Congratulations. Congratulations. Nobody will have reason to pity you this year. Congratulations now. Congratulate two more people as you get ready to be out for the next service to take off. Congratulate someone around you. Brand new season.